Guys, welcome to Crazy Burger. I'm a little bit late to the game here. This was July's game of the month. I'm going to go through it and give you my thoughts anyway before we jump into August's game of the month, which should be coming in the next few days at the time of this video, which is going to be Doodle World Redrawn. I think the full title is, which I've already played on this channel before. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to get a heads up on that game. I played through the Steam version a couple of months back, and it's pretty good. It's just pretty similar to the first game. Anyway, let's talk about July's game of the month. Let's talk about July's game of the month. This is Magic and Legend Time Knights from the Retro Room. Now, I really enjoyed last month's game. Retro Room game, big too small, was fantastic. Thoroughly enjoyed it. I played it solidly for the last month and a half till I completed it. It certainly frustrated me towards the end, but I was so focused to try and finish it, and we did. It's a brilliant, brilliant game. Now, let's have a look at this one. This one probably is the poorest game so far, having played it, and it only takes maybe around 25 30 minutes to actually complete. So it's probably one of those that we probably could do without, I would say. But anyway, this is it. It's Magic and Legend. It's kind of a platformer game, and it looks kind of an RPG, but it's an platformer game where you need to destroy all the aliens on each level. There's not a lot of logic to it. It's really just destroy the aliens. You've got a sort of limit of total number of aliens to destroy in each level, and you destroy them, move on to the next one, then you get a final boss at the end. Like I say, it really only takes about 30 minutes or so to actually go through. So what I'm going to do is I'll play through the game, and I'll talk you through the game in real time as I'm actually playing it, and give you my thoughts as we go. I think it's Game Boy Advance. No, not Game Boy Advance. Game Boy Color, sorry, that this is based on. And it looks nice enough. It's pretty cool, but it is very, very basic. Let's get this game played, and we'll sort of give you my thoughts as we go. Okay, guys, here we are. I've updated the VS, and this is Magic and Legend Time Knight. So let's have a look at some of the details. I've played this for more than a minute. I played it on the handheld to completion, so we'll try and play through it on the video, and I'll commentate in real time. Usually, I don't do that just because the sound sometimes isn't particularly amazing. But anyway, there's some details of it. You're basically two boys, I think it is, and yeah, the story's a bit stupid. It doesn't really make a lot of sense, really. It's just a silly story made up to sort of suit into the game that they've made. So you've got two options. You've got jump and attack, and you can switch between the two characters by pressing the select button. Pretty straightforward, so let's get stuck in. Okay, obviously from the Retro Room, who now have Quest Arrest and Big Too Small and Gelatinous. So I've had a mixture of quality from them. I think Gelatinous was probably pretty poor. So let's have a look at this. The other two were pretty good, I guess. So you got a few options. Press start to play. You can play easy, normal, or hard. It just really changes how many lives you actually start with. But honestly, I'm not really sure. I'm just going to stick with easy so we can actually get through the game. And here you go, the story. You've got two characters. Now, I think it's if you want to probably a more of a challenge, you should maybe choose the default character, because obviously then you need to sort of have the close combat. If you want a slightly easier game, then choose the other character, because you can obviously fire at fire at enemies from a distance, so it makes it a little bit easier. So there's a silly story going on with some nonsense. There's aliens attacked. You need to go and kill all the aliens or enemies on the level. Pretty straightforward. So jump, and you've got obviously, see, the close combat is absolutely useless. Now, right away, something that sort of stuck out to me was the collision detection is absolutely shockingly bad. And when you play this character, it certainly makes things a little bit easier. And it definitely reminded me slightly of a sort of extended version of B Best 2. That's what it kind of reminded me of a little bit. Obviously, that's a single screen. This is more like, obviously, a little bit more exploration than that, but yeah, okay, I've just lost a life already. Now, if you use all your lives, you usually get sent back to the start, which is an absolute pain, and which is something I found quite annoying. You can see graphics are very basic. It's clearly probably been made by one of those sort of a GB Maker platforms. I think that's what it's called. I might be wrong. It just seems that kind of basic style that it probably makes sense that that's what it is. Let's have a look. If you press the start button, it tells you how many aliens you've got left to kill. So I've got sort of 7 left to kill, and that tells you how many lives you've got left. So yeah, I've got plenty in scores. So it seems a bit pointless to me. Anyway, let's move on. Yeah, so it's very basic, and yeah, it's probably one of those games that once you've done it, you're not going to come back to it. But I guess for a quick blast, the fact that it takes maybe 30 minutes, you'll certainly play it. It's not a terrible game as such, it's just not one that's going to stick in your memory at all, as being a particularly amazing game. The sort of jumping mechanics, it's quite slidey. So it is a bit tricky when you sort of try to do some of these jumping parts. I've just slid into the character and all the way back to the beginning, which is just stupidly frustrating. There's really no need for that. Now, I think so far the game of the month has actually been really good. This is the fourth game. The three games before that were absolutely fantastic. But yeah, I think this one's definitely took a dip in quality. Now, we've got a bonus stage we can go through. Not sure what the point of this is, maybe just to sort of gain some more points or something, or gather up some of the fruit that are on the level. I have no idea what the point of this is, just, and even the game still, what's this all about? Are the boys like to dress up or something, or I don't know, it just, sometimes the idea of the game seems random as heck, it makes no sense, and yeah, I think the whole game is a bit like that. Okay, there's a story going on, but does it make any sense? What was the point of that bonus level? There was no point to it. It's just there for the sake of it. It's random. It's really stupid. Just, yeah, pointless. Anyway, that's the first level. And the other levels are kind of similar until maybe you get to the last few levels. I think it's 5 levels, if I'm right. And you've obviously the style changes a little bit. You've got sort of slightly different characters. And sort of different weapons, but honestly the game is practically the same. You've got more enemies to kill on each level as you go, and see he's dressed up as a knight this time. Don't know, it's some kind of strange setup. I don't get it at all. It makes no sense. But anyway, I think I'll play through a little bit more and then we'll sort of fast forward to the end so that you can actually see the collision detection is just absolutely shockingly bad at times. And then it just causes unnecessary frustration. Don't really know why. There's random coins to collect as well, which make no sense. But yeah, as well as there's some doors you can sort of go through that sort of take you to different stages, as you can see here. You can't actually get there. Oh, there's spikes, which kill you randomly. Anyway, guys, you get the idea. Not massively impressed with the game, but it's okay. It's not bad, not the worst. Very basic. You'll probably play it once and never play it again. But it does get a little bit trickier as you get through. There's more enemies to sort of destroy and try and find, so the challenge does get a bit sort of trickier, so to speak. It's not a massive challenging game, but I think if the game was more like the last few levels, it'd probably be better. And definitely they need more levels. I think if it was maybe 5 more levels and sort of changed the overall game length up a little bit, it would probably be a decent enough game. But as it stands, it is probably a really sort of poor to average game at best. Certainly worth playing, I would say, just to experience it, but I don't think it will stick in your mind. Like I said, it's not one that you're going to say, oh, that was an amazing experience. I doubt very much you're going to say that. It's just one of those, it feels like a cartridge filler, to be honest. That's the best way to describe it. Now, personally, I think this game would have been better off included as like a unlockable secret game. That would have probably made sense, but instead of being a full-on game, because I don't really think there's massive value in this game at all. Completing a game in 20-30 minutes is not really what I want to see on any cart collection at all, to be honest, unless it's a secret unlockable game that you get for free. These bonus levels just seem silly. I don't really see what the point is, to be honest. It's just a sort of little addition, and if you die, that's it basically finished. You need to start all over again. So there's not an awful lot of logic to it. It's just there for the sake of it. But yeah, if you die, you're done. I've no idea what's going on. Did the developers have any idea what was going on? Probably not. Let's just make a random game element that makes no sense. Mean, the sort of jumping mechanics as well seem really floaty, like there's no gravity in this game, or very little. It's not the same as Earth, that's for sure. You try jumping like that in real life, you'll never float. Yeah. Anyway, that's just games for you, isn't it, in general. Think first time I played these bonus levels, I actually died quite quickly. Yeah, just like that. When you stop concentrating, you die instantly. Anyway, let's move on. Okay, so I'm kind of getting the idea that the two sort of main characters are roughly travelling through time to sort of rid of all the aliens that have sort of landed in Earth through different time periods. I guess that's the whole point of the game design. And stuff, but yeah, it's a bit silly, really, isn't it? But yeah, it is what it is. Now, certainly, these last few levels are more interesting than the first couple, I'd say. They're certainly more challenging if you look at it. You've got more aliens to kill, it certainly makes it more challenging. The sort of levels are bigger. There's certainly a lot of backtracking goes on as well. In some parts, you get a little bit frustrated in where you're going. It certainly gets better. I wish that the full game was more like the last few levels, to be honest, and there was more levels to it. Be certainly a better game as it is. It kind of just feels very basic, to me. It's not the worst, let's be honest. It's not the worst game at all that you've ever played. It just seems certainly a drop in quality to the games that we've already seen that are going to be on Indie Heroes Collection. The last month was fantastic from Retro Room, Big Too Small. Admittedly, it probably was quite a basic game, but the amount of levels, the challenge there was fantastic, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. But anyway, let's move on a little bit. Okay, so the last level, the crown jewel heist in London. I think this is the last level anyway. So you get two characters. Magic has a baton by the looks of it, and Legend has daggers. So the crown jewels have been stolen. We need to stop them. Yeah, it's all a bit bonkers, really, the story, but I guess it is what it is. Guess Switchblade, that's what it is. Oh. I mean, I think so far it's only took me about 20 minutes to get to this point, so it's not a huge game at all. I thought the last level 4, was actually good fun. It was certainly a little bit trickier to try and find all the enemies. It's still not a huge challenge, to be fair, but it certainly was more fun than the opening few levels, which were just a little bit boring. But yeah, let's switch to the other character just to see what it's like. He's also dressed as a policeman, but yeah, I can see that close combat makes the game horribly difficult because the collision detection is really, I think it's just a bit off to make that even plausible to actually go the other character. It just makes it the game far too frustrating, and it's not enjoyable at all. I think we've got 35 aliens to actually kill on this level. That's quite a lot. It's quite a jump from the previous level, which was 20. And see, this collision detection is just a joke. Oh, that's the only thing I really don't like. The sort of jump mechanics too floaty. You slide quite a lot, which is weird as if you're on ice skates. So ideally, you want to try and clear the enemies as you see them. You don't want to have to backtrack through the sort of levels. I think you can go through these doors as well. No visitors allowed. Oh. Signed the Queen. Oh, she's still alive in this game. Yeah, probably done just before she sadly passed away. Yeah, there's sections in here you don't want to miss. Otherwise, you'll be frustrated. Don't know what these wee white guys are. Some kind of aliens, I'm guessing. Yeah. Don't want to miss any. There's probably some hiding somewhere or floating around awkwardly. Yeah, randomly going on their own way, wherever they're going or whatever they're doing, just moving back and forth. Oh, where did that one go? There was one there, wasn't there? Ah, so sometimes it's a bit frustrating that the enemies sometimes disappear off the screen and they won't appear again until you actually move. Look, there it was. There, you see that? Come on. Yeah, don't make a lot of sense. Now, guys, let me know what you think of this game. Have you played it? Do you like it? Do you enjoy it? Unless it's just me, I just feel it's not the greatest. It's just very, very average at best. I just wished we didn't get games like this all the time, but I get it. Sometimes that's what happens. I guess we're not always going to get bangers that we've had so far on the Indie Heroes collection. Next month's, which is obviously now this month at the time of the video, August, is going to be Doodle World Redrawn. So hopefully that'll drop in the next couple of days, and I'll play through that as well. But basically, if you've played Doodle World already, then you might be a wee bit disappointed. It's basically the same game, except the levels are extended a little bit. So if you've never played it before, then you'll probably love it. But if you've played it before, then you might not get the same out of it at all. I just don't think there's enough game there to sort of warrant getting it again. But they've added it to the collection. It's still a decent game. I just feel it's not got enough. Obviously, it's just Doodle World Redrawn. It's not technically Doodle World 2. Anyway, guys, I'll sort of pause this and we can sort of fast forward to the end of the game where we're sort of fighting the end of level boss once I've defeated all the aliens on this level. Okay, so we've finally got to the final boss. We've stopped the jewels from being stolen. We've jumped onto their spaceship and now we're, I don't know, in space. Avoid, kill small aliens, hit all the targets, destroy the nuclear core. Then we can finish. So blah, 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 blah. We're on the final boss. Happy days. Okay, let's move on, please. So I think you need to destroy all these aliens, then we can sort of take effect to the sort of core here, then you can go in and destroy the core and finish the actual game. So it's pretty much the same as the full game's been going. But yeah, sometimes in the last level there, the enemies would just appear, not appear. Weird. To randomly appear in front of you even though you've already been there. It just seems a bit odd. Then once you get hit by them, there's about 3 second delay before you can actually hit them again. Yeah, that's very, very odd. Now they just seem to come floating towards you like a magnet. Which is fine, that makes it easier for me anyway. I need to destroy those target things. Yeah, they made it obvious, it's just a target. Just hit the target and there's obviously few targets on the body which we can try and take out. Oh jeez, sometimes it's just frustrating trying to hit the sort of enemies. Nope, getting there. How many more to go? I love those floaty mechanics, absolutely frustrating. Oh, got you. Oh, darn. I think we've only got one more to go, and then I think that's it. Game over. Oh, no. See, oh, I've reset the thing. Dear. How annoying. What the heck's going on there? It just seemed to randomly move to a different location. That is just bizarre. Yeah. I think I can just go and hit the final one now, I believe, yeah. Is that it? No? Oh, there's one there. Yay! I think that's it. Oh, let's blow this alien to smithereens. Is that it? That's it. Yeah. Right, happy days. We've saved the day. What? What? I think that's basically it, guys. Again, it's worth playing through, I guess, just once, just for experience. It'll take you about 20 to 30 minutes. Not the most amazing game. It's certainly got a few flaws here and there. So I had some mild fun towards the end of the game. But yeah, it's not amazing. Anyway, guys, it is what it is. Thanks very much for watching, and we'll catch you again in the next one. Bye for now. Oh no, there's going to be another game. Help!